And it's time to put the new cutting edge and the deflector on the snowplow. So I'm gonna let the birds out right now, and then we'll get into the shop and I'll show you what's going on, and we're gonna put this stuff together. So welcome to Michigan, welcome to winter. All right, it's a chilly one out there this morning. You get a fire going in here, get the shop warmed up. That should do it. Let it draft. It's time to get this golf cart out of here and bring the plow in and work on it in here. There's a little bit of snow out there, so I'm gonna make sure I shovel some of that off of there, but it's time to do this. Winter is here, you guys. The fire is nice and cozy though. Check it out. You might be asking, why do I turn on the kerosene heater and then open the big door? Well, the kerosene heater is just to cut the chill in the building when I get started. So I'm gonna turn that off now because the fire and the wood stove is going so good. I'm gonna leave this door open to work on the truck. It's not that bad out. It's like 33, 32 degrees. I mean, there's snow there on the ground. It's still snowing right now, but it's not that bad. So time to turn this off. That's what I always do. I always heat up my little area because this is where I work. In the shop right there. I work from this area and I bring everything in the middle here and work on it from here. I like having the door open if it's not too cold. If it's just staying, you know, if it's 20 degrees or below 29, say, I'll shut the door and just leave all the heat going. But in this case, it's not that bad out. So let's get the truck hooked up to the plow, bring the plow in here, and I'll show you everything that we've got going. And the parts that I got yesterday should be good. Shouldn't take that long. But there's a couple things I gotta do. Gotta cut some holes. Gotta cut an edge of this deflector. So I'll show you what I mean. All right, before we tear into the plow, I wanna show you the package of the bolts and the nuts. I want to keep this kind of clean. This Coleman stove I'm working on right now. Wow, look at these things, they're huge. Squared off, that's good. These carriage bolts, that way it's so much easier when you are squared off to put in and take out. Nice locking nuts there. Big washer, it's got that nylon end. So yep, that's it. This is a 2018 plow, so I think it's an original cutting edge on there. I don't remember changing it on this one. So it's been what 5 years of plowing on it, and it's time. There's like a little bit of wear left, and you'll be able to see it when I start taking it off. So all right, let's get the impact gun out. All right, let me tell you what's gonna happen. When I take that last one off, these things gonna drop. I'll drop it here on this side. So, look at all that. just dirt. The paint's in pretty good condition down there still. I'll show you the difference between this old one and the new one. The old, or the new one here, is 6 inches tall. That's what this was originally. Now we're down to 3.5. So, you know, 3.5 inches wear on that bad boy right here. That's quite a bit. So it's time, and these things are thick. I think they're 5/8. I think they're more than a half inch. Yeah, it looks like 5/8 to me. Is that right? 5/8? No, they're half. It's a half inch. But heavy duty stuff right there. Time to put this one on. I want to show you guys the difference between the old one here and the new one. Look at that. It's quite a big, I don't know why they did that, but yeah, there's a half inch difference in between the two, isn't it? Just before I put it on, it just makes me feel better. It probably doesn't do anything but use up my supply. These things are heavy. You can put this in there to help jockey it into position. This at least helps you line it up and get a washer and a nut. Just enough to start it until we swing up that other end. All right, so now that's done, and what we're gonna do next is I'm gonna drop it down, clean up these tools, get out of the way, and then we'll work on this deflector up top. Show you what that's all about. Now that that's on, it sits up a lot higher. It's gonna be a lot better for the plow to travel. It'll be almost like it was brand new again. So I might be able to adjust those chains again. And it's just going to ride better because I have 3.5 more inches or 3 more inches of height on that new cutting edge. So that performance is going to be a lot better. All right, so these are just 1/2 inch. And I got to save these because these little bars right here, see these little, I guess they're hard nylon bars. Well, I got 3 on mine. And they have to go on top of the old, or on top of the new deflector. This is the part we keep. This is the part that goes to the dumpster. All right, the trick is, since this one here is an 8-foot plow, 8-foot blade, that is a 9-foot deflector. So we're gonna have 1 foot of really good rubberized material, probably for something on the workbench left over. So I gotta get it clamped up here, lined up the way I want it, drill my holes in it, and reattach these bracing, and then we're good to go plow. Probably need another clamp like that. She is lined up. Yep. And what I think I'll do is, because I hung it over, away from the steel up here, I'm going to see if I can get my drill in there, my skill saw, without tearing stuff up, if you know what I'm saying. Oh yeah. She wanted to kick back, didn't she? Look at that. What a nice piece of material for the bench or something. For battery to sit on, we're keeping that. That's a good piece. Look at that bad boy. 3/8 thick, I believe. Hard rubber. good stuff. I guess you can start out one way and work all the way down. You just don't want wrinkles. That's what I'm saying. You don't want any bubbles in there. So, and that's what these things are all about. These things help to keep this thing from tearing and flopping all around. I remember before these were available, these things would just fly up and tear all around the bolt heads. So these things come in handy. What you have to do is go through that way, and it makes like an angled hole. Then you got to go back in just to sort of clean it up, because you got an angled hole because it came in from an angle. You know, it's so much better to do these kind of jobs on when there's not a snowstorm going on. I can't tell you how many times we've been stuck in snowstorms before and things have happened. Well, that's, oh, come on. That's like the worst time for things to go bad, because when there's no stores open to get parts, of course it's the worst ever. Just so they're snug, that's all they need. Don't need to be out there squashing all the material. Just make it so it's tight, so it doesn't come off. That's it. Couple of dits, and that's it. Only two more to go. Well, that's it. All right, you guys, thanks for watching today. I hope you liked seeing that go together like that. It's not that difficult to do. It's a very easy job. It's, you know, as long as you have the right tools to do stuff, you guys can do anything, really. As long as you're not scared to do it, just try it. So thanks for watching, you guys. I'm gonna get out there and push this in and get it around. I'm gonna take it around a few of these little subdivision streets that are nearby and just kind of work it in, get that angle, that hard angle cut off the bottom, and it'll be ready for snow plowing this winter. So thanks for coming around and seeing what I'm up to again here in the shop, and we'll talk soon, you guys. God bless, and get in your workshop.